Violence undermines your might.
Now, beg for your lives.
Okay, I'm doing this rant today, well, because I want to. As you can tell from the title, it's about the PS4. And for anyone that knows me, I haven't looked upon the PS4 very favorably for most of its life. And I have my reasons for that, but that's not what the rant is about today. But before we get to my main point of today's rant, I want to give you some backstory. Okay, so I have owned a PS4 since it came out. Not day one, but within the first month. I still remember the day. I was on Walmart.com and I was looking at the store that's closest to me and they said they had some available. I was like, okay, wow, they have some PS4 available, because at the time you couldn't find any. They were selling out like crazy. So the moment I saw that, I called them up and asked, do you still have some PS4s there? And they said they had about 3. So after that, I said, okay, I'll be down there right now to go pick one up. So after that, I hung up. Me and my brother rushed down to Walmart and I bought my PS4. I was so excited. I was like, yes, I finally have a new next-gen console. I can't wait to play the crap out of it. And sadly, right now, there's not too much to own for it. And so I'll pick up Killzone Shadowfall. When the PS4 was announced, I was actually looking forward to Killzone Shadowfall. That's why it was the first game that I bought. The reason why I wanted to buy that game was because I liked the past entries in the series. So why not get it? So when I got home, I plugged it in, set up the console, and inserted the game. My brother was still there with me, and he wanted to see what the PS4 had to offer, because the last console he ever bought, well, technically it was the 360, but the last Sony one was the PS2. He never had the PS3. So he wanted to see what the PS4, you know, what it was like. But things quickly got embarrassing. The game had a long, boring opening cutscene. It felt like 20 to 25 minutes before you could even start playing the damn game. Then when you finally do get to play, the game was not fun at all. The controls were horrible, level design sucked, and the characters and story were just flat out boring as fuck. But to be fair, a boring story and characters is pretty common for Killzone. Killzone has never really ever had an interesting story or an interesting character. They've always been lacking in that department. But anyways, I could tell my brother was bored watching me play this game, and I was clearly bored playing this fucking game. After that, I did try a few more games on the PS4, but most were just games that were already on the PS3, like Assassin's Creed Black Flag. A lot of the games at launch were just PS3 games on the PS4. The same thing for the 360 and Xbox One. They didn't really have much to offer when they came out, which is why I was so upset at these consoles, because they had nothing to buy and nothing to play. The games I did play later on and ended up playing the most on the PS4 was NHL 15, which sucked, and NHL 16, which was much better. And think about that, that's sad, right? The game I played the most so far on the PS4 is NHL 16. I've not played any game more than that one. That's pretty fucking sad when a sports game is the game that I play the most, but I digress. I was quickly bored of the console, and it didn't help that every game I bought had to download and install. It would always take like a whole fucking day. It was just bullshit, and in my mind was like, if this is a console, why should I have to install the game on it? Isn't that the whole benefit to a console compared to the PCs of old? You know, you didn't have to install your games. You could just pop it in and play, and PCs were like, you know, you have to install them. Now it's like, what, now you gotta install on these consoles too? That's not very appealing. It's crap. I was thinking to myself, there is no way this was a true next-gen console. It sucked. So eventually I built my own gaming PC, and I have been happy ever since. Games look better, they run better, and the games cost less, because there are sales everywhere, every day, all the time. Not to mention getting games for free, like Skyrim Special Edition and Bioshock Collection, just for owning the games already. That's awesome, while people on the consoles had to rebuy them if they wanted to play them again. But like any console, I knew there would be some worthwhile exclusives for the PS4 eventually. While I still do believe there are barely a handful of games that I would even consider worth owning for the console, but regardless, there are some. So recently I have bought 3 PS4 games. Kingdom Hearts HD 1.5 plus 2.5, Crash Bandicoot Insane Trilogy, and Dissidia Final Fantasy NT. Even though I liked these games, the install times were still garbage. Kingdom Hearts HD took all fucking night. I left it on rest mode so it would install during the night. I shouldn't have to do that, but I had to. Crash also took a whole fucking night to do that as well. And then Dissidia, the day I got it, I installed it. It took the whole fucking day to install. I didn't even get to play it until the next day. You know, I could have still played it while it was doing that, but I was still playing another game that I'm going to review soon. So, which is why it wasn't too bad, but still, it shouldn't take a whole day to install. But regardless, they were installed now, and I was finally able to enjoy these games. That is, until yesterday. A console that I have hardly ever used in the 4 years that I have owned it decided to shit the bed. It kept freezing after I would select the game, or the settings, or whatever. No matter what I did, it would freeze. It would just not stop freezing. So I had to keep turning the console off, turning it back on, watch it freeze again, turn it off, turn it back on, watch it freeze again. It was so fucking annoying. So I decided to go into safe mode and rebuild the database. It took all day doing this shit, and it did nothing because that froze too. So by now, I was fucking pissed. A whole day wasted. I couldn't even keep playing Dissidia. So I said, you know what, fuck it. I initialized my PS4, basically meaning resetting it back to factory settings. So by doing this, all my saves were gone, and all the games I installed were gone as well. So I had to reinstall my games, which is something I was not looking forward to, but strangely, something happened. Dissidia finished installing in under an hour. Crash took 3 minutes to install. Kingdom Hearts finished in under 2 hours. It might have been about an hour and a half, but I don't know, somewhere around an hour and a half to 2 hours. It's still not as fast as I think they could and should be, but much more faster than before. Games on the PS4, for me, used to take 6 to 12 hours to download and install, but now they install quickly. I was blown away by this. Completely blown away. I was like, what the fuck is happening? And I ask myself, why does my PS4 work better now than when it was brand new? All these years, I wouldn't buy games for it because, for starters, there wasn't much to buy on it. And plus, I didn't want to deal with those install times. Does anyone know why now my PS4 works better now than before? Is this all I had to do? Just reset my PS4? Sounds odd, right? Yeah, let me buy a brand new PS4. And before I do anything, let me reset it real quick to make sure it fucking works right. But besides that, now I'm kind of actually excited to buy some more PS4 exclusives. Don't get me wrong, I still hate the controller, and I'm still not very pleased with the console. But finally, for once, I am actually glad I at least own the damn console. Here's hoping that God of War is actually good and not just a huge cinematic interactive fucking movie. I need my fast hack and slash gameplay. I don't want it to be a fucking movie, okay? That's all they've shown so far, which I'm so fucking worried about this game. I'm so worried that it's gonna suck so badly. Oh god, I hope not. I hope it is not suck, but I'm feeling that it is. So, besides that, I will be getting more PS4 games to play and show on this channel now, and I'll review some upcoming ones. The first PS4 review I'm announcing right now will be Dissidia. So for all the shit I gave to the PS4, while I don't fully forgive Sony for all this crap, I don't quite hate it as much as I did before. It's kind of odd. This is truly one of the first times that I'm actually kind of enjoying playing the console, which is very odd for me to say after 4 years of saying it's the worst console ever, and I still kind of believe that. It's still one of the worst consoles ever, but, you know, I don't hate it as much. I still kind of hate it, but I don't hate it as much. Okay, that's it for this rant. Letting you guys know, I'm going to start ranting more because one thing I like to do is rant. It's always been something I've been good at, sometimes to a fault, but hey, if there's any topic, whether it's being about a console, games, PC, movies, let me know in the comments, or you can follow me on Twitter or my Facebook page and let me know on there as well. and I will rant about it. I can pretty much rant about anything, whether it's something that people will agree with or people won't agree with. It doesn't matter. I'm gonna rant. Ranting is ranting. I shall rant about anything. It doesn't matter what. Whew. So again, that's it for now. Stay tuned for more upcoming rants and upcoming playthroughs with my wife and some more reviews coming out soon. And until next time, keep on gaming, gamers.
I almost enjoyed myself.